بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. الحمد لله رب العالمين. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله, I'm back with my new video concerning refutation of Christiana Princess, the pig of Barnyard. عباد الخروف, عباد الغنم, عباد الماعز. I am saying he is slave of goat. His God is goat. His God is lamp. He is a lamp worshipper. He is a goat worshipper. He is a sheep worshipper. He is slave of goat. He is slave of lamp. He is slave of goat. He is slave of lamp. He is slave of sheep. So inshallah ta'ala, in this new video, as usual, I am going to demonstrate how this charlatan liar, he lied against Imam al-Qurtubi. He lied again this liar. She twisted and took out of the context and totally hide all the other parts.
Let me get your busted, my friend. My friend, you do not know what are you talking about. You are just a kid like the rest of you. I'm not insulting you. I will prove it to you in a second. Have you ever heard a verse in the Quran? It says, وَجَعَلْنَاهُ نَسَبًا وَصِهْرًا.
Yes.
What that verse mean?
Okay. What's the problem with the ayah? I don't understand what you're.
Do you know what the problem with this ayah? This ayah teaching, if you go to the interpretation, you will see it says you can have sex with your daughter if she is a daughter out of marriage. My friend, I can prove it. Do you want to challenge me?
I don't.
Do you want to challenge me? If I show you the interpretation, it says that.
Sure. Go ahead.
All right. I hate it when a Muslim he challenges me because always I cannot prove that I am telling the truth. This is Tafsir al-Qurtubi. This is the official government website of the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia. Tafsir al-Qurtubi, page number 264, chapter 25, verse number 54. It says here that it's allowed for a Muslim man to have sex with the mother and the daughter he have from that mother because she is not his daughter from marriage. So if she is not a daughter from marriage, therefore she is a daughter from adultery, therefore she is not forbidden, for she is not considered to be a daughter. For Islam only consider a daughter to be a daughter if she is a daughter from marriage. Therefore, you can have sex with the mother and your daughter from your blood. And this is the teaching of Allah. And he is saying, this is according to the most accurate opinion of the deen, the religion, the most accurate. And this is what all the scholars agree upon. What do you say? My friend, if I prove to you that this is a true, what you will do? It's in the front of you. I mean, are you saying to me it's not true? It's in the front of you. Listen, Abdul, I have no time for kids. It's in the front of you. This is the official government website of the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia. This is Tafsir al-Qurtubi, page number 264. And this is the chapter 25, verse number 54. And you are saying to me it's not true?
I'm saying it's definitely not true.
Well, prove me wrong then. Okay, go. Show me reference. Go ahead. I'm listening.
Okay, show me any Quran ayah or any hadith.
Let your dad call me, please. Come on. Show me any ayah. I just show you an ayah.
First of all, Imam al-Qurtubi rahimahullah, as you can see in the screen, in the Arabic, Imam al-Qurtubi was quoting opinions of many scholars. And among the scholars, it included Ibn al-Arabi. And the Christian peanut quoted only one opinion. That is opinion of Ibn al-Arabi. If you scroll bit down and see what Imam al-Qurtubi rahimahullah said in Arabic, clearly this part totally exposes this liar and dishonesty of this liar. How this liar takes out of context and totally rejects all the part, hides all the part that goes against her, hides the response. Imam al-Qurtubi rahimahullah clearly said, he said, قلت قلت اختلاف الفقهاء في النكاح الرجل ابنته من الزنا أو أخته أو بنت ابنه من الزنا فحرم ذلك قوم من ابن القاسم إلى آخر السطر. So let's translate this part. This part is very important. Why? Imam al-Qurtubi rahimahullah clearly says that there is difference of opinion and disagreement between our scholars, our jurists, concerning whether it's halal or haram for a man to marry his daughter from fornication. They have differences of opinion. So Imam al-Qurtubi clearly says this one. Clearly says there is differences of opinion. But this liar, he didn't show this part in order to deceive his brainless sheeps. Of course, he's Ibad al-Kharuf, Abd al-Ghanam, Abd al-Kharuf, slave of goat. His god is lamb, his god is sheep. Imam al-Qurtubi rahimahullah clearly said, I said, jurists or Islamic scholars differed concerning marriage of a man with his daughter from fornication or his sister, meaning or his sister from fornication, or daughter of his son, meaning from fornication. Among them, so he's quoting different opinions. He's quoting different opinions, but this liar, he quoted only one opinion and he totally rejected all the opinions. What Imam Qurtubi listed. Imam Qurtubi said, among them who held and deemed this marriage as forbidden are Ibn al-Qasim. And this is the opinion of Imam Abu Hanifa and his companions. And other scholars held and deemed this marriage as permissible. Among them are Abd al-Malik. And this is the opinion of Imam al-Shafi'i. And this was preceded in Surah Nisa very well. So this is what Imam al-Qurtubi said. He brings two conflicting opinions. He brings two different opinions. And he, you know, at the beginning he clearly said, I said there are differences. قُلْتُ اِخْتَلَافَ الْفُقَهَا. The jurist differed concerning this matter, whether marriage of a man with his daughter from fornication is halal or haram. And this part totally blows the liar into pieces. This part, this last part, totally destroys and blows up this liar into pieces. Why? I will read in Arabic. قَالَ الْفَرَّاءِ. So Al-Farra is a very good scholar. Imam al-Qurtubi quotes what Al-Farra said. قال الفراء النسب الذي لا أحل نكاحه وقاله الزجاج وهو قول علي بن أبي طالب رضي الله عنه. This is a very crushing blow which this liar hided and took out of context, which he didn't show to his brain dead chips, zombies, because it will totally destroy him into pieces. I have read this part because this part totally demonstrated this guy is a charlatan and liar, and he didn't read this part. Why? Because Al-Farra rahimahullah said, the lineage is what makes the marriage forbidden. And as the judge said, this as well. And this is also the opinion of Ali bin Abi Talib. And this is also the opinion of Ali bin Abi Talib. Who is Ali bin Abi Talib? Ali bin Abi Talib radiallahu anhu is cousin of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he's very close companion of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But why didn't this liar read this part and translate to his branded followers? Why? Because this part totally kills him, destroys and blows him into pieces. Because here it says clearly, the lineage is what makes the marriage forbidden. And this is the opinion of Ali bin Abi Talib. Game over. Because this is the opinion of Ali bin Abi Talib. So in conclusion, marriage of a man with his daughter from fornication is not permissible. Why? Because his daughter is from his lineage. And Al-Farra said, the lineage is what makes the marriage forbidden. And this is the opinion of Ali bin Abi Talib. This is the opinion of Ali bin Abi Talib. Who else you have a greater scholar than Ali bin Abi Talib? He's the companion of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allahu Akbar. This lie hired this part from his brain dead followers. Charlatan. Brain dead ships. Brain dead zombies. He quoted only one opinion. Whereas Imam al-Qurtubi rahimahullah said there is differences of opinion between our jurists and Islamic scholars. And this liar didn't show this part. And the most crushing blow is the opinion of Ali bin Abi Talib is lineage is what makes the marriage forbidden. In other words, you cannot marry your daughter from fornication. Why? Because she's your lineage. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. And guess what? Imam al-Baghawi rahimahullah interpreted this verse the same way. The same way the opinion of Ali bin Abi Talib radiallahu anhu, the opinion of Az-Zajjaj rahimahullah, and the opinion of Al-Farra rahimahullah. That is the lineage is what makes the marriage forbidden. Let me read what Imam Al-Baghawi rahimahullah said. So he comments on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying, it is he who created from water, which means from nutfah, a human being, and made him a relative by lineage and marriage, which means he made for him lineage and relatives from marriage. It is said the marriage from lineage is prohibited. The same opinion of Ali bin Abi Talib al-Farra al-Zajjaj. This is the exact same thing what Imam al-Baghawi says in his tafsir. It is said the marriage from lineage is prohibited, while marriage from sihr is allowed. Sihr in Arabic literally means relatives through marriage. And it is said, meaning by the scholars, this is the correct saying. Allahu Akbar. Al-Baghawi confirms that there is the opinion of Ali ibn Abi Talib radiallahu anhu and Farra and as a judge. Marriage from lineage is haram. Whom you should trust? Should we trust Imam al-Qurtubi, Imam al-Baghawi, and you know, even before them, Ali ibn Abi Talib radiallahu anhu, companion of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Should we trust them or this liar, hidden troll behind the screen? Now let me show the clear cut how his god, his lamp god, allows incest in his so-called holy moly Bible. Let's read some passages. And he have guts to talk about Islam. He doesn't even have idea what is in his own Bible. He's clueless donkey. If you talk about Bible, you know what he will do? He will run into Quran. Muhammad, 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 Muhammad. Islam, Islam. Always. He can't even defend his own Bible. Always he will see this donkey attacking Islam. But he will not see him defending his Bible, which was written by alleged unknown authors. So, the first verse which allows incest is in Genesis 38. Okay, the Bible teaches that if a man died being childless, his brother should sleep with his wife, meaning have sexual relations with his wife, in order to provide children for his brother who died childless. Judah got a wife for Ir, his firstborn, and her name was Tamar. But Ir, Judah's firstborn, was wicked in Lord's sight, so the Lord put him to death. Then Judah said to Onan, sleep with your brother's wife and fulfill your duty. Fulfill your duty. This is so comical. Then Judah said to Onan, sleep with your brother's wife and fulfill your duty to her as brother-in-law. So we can see clearly that Bible teaches that if a man dies childless and he has a wife and his wife became widowed and he died childless and doesn't have any son or daughter, it's duty, you know, it's duty of his brother to sleep with his dead brother's wife and raise offspring for his brother. Fulfill your duty to her as brother-in-law to raise up offspring for your brother. But Onan knew that child would not be his. So whenever he slept with his brother's wife, he spilled his semen on the ground to keep from providing offspring for his brother. What he did was wicked, you know, wicked in Lord's sight, you know, in his lamb god's sight. So the Lord put him to death because he didn't commit incest with his brother's wife. His goat god felt it was very wicked, so he put him to death just for not merely sleeping with his dead brother's wife. Irony. Yet this liar, he attacks Islam. And by the way, the Bible says in Timothy 3:16, all scripture is God breath and useful for teaching, rebuking, and training in righteousness. The Bible teaches that brother and sister can kiss each other. Songs of Solomon 8:1. Oh, I wish you were my brother who nursed at my mother's breast. Then I could kiss you no matter who was watching, and no one would criticize me. And this liar, these charlatans have guts to attack, which teaches chastity, modesty. See this irony of this liar. Alhamdulillah wa salatu wa salamu ala rasulillah wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam tasliman kathira. Alhamdulillah rabbil alameen. This is the end. Inshallah, I'll end.